Fine, let me start. In today's session, we are going to continue with the transmission characteristics of a optical fiber. Okay, we have already started this. Hope you remember, it's long back. We have started with the attenuation. Actually, there are broadly two types, attenuation and disruption or dispersion. Out of which we have started with the attenuation first. Attenuation is loss of the strength, the power, and there are some mechanisms which will cause this attenuation, the loss of the energy of the signal. That signal is your light signal, which propagates through the optical fiber. We have already seen one type in this. I think we had started about absorption. Okay? We have to look into each one of it in detail. So we have started with the attenuation. What is attenuation? Then what are the different mechanisms that causes attenuation that I have listed just now? Absorption, scattering, linear, non-linear, okay? bending losses. So, and even for attenuation, how you calculate, I indicate attenuation in dB, we have seen. Then the numerical value of this ratio, input by output, the ratio, how to get that, we have seen. And based on this, we have even taken one numerical problem also we have seen. Today, let us deal with material absorption losses. So, in the optical fibers, material absorption. So, as the name suggests, it is material related. So, material absorption loss, this is the first type of mechanism which we are dealing now, which causes attenuation. So, absorption, you know, right? Taking the energy from one thing. So, that is absorption. Material absorption loss, it is a mechanism related to the material composition. I am talking about optical fiber here. The optical fiber is made of silica, the sand, right? So while fabricating the optical fiber, even that counts, the fabrication process, as well as the material composition, how you are making this glass, optical fiber, cable, glass. So here you come across this material absorption loss. So it results in the dissipation of some of the transmitted optical power as a heat in the waveguide. So sometimes you may feel, even in some normal, two wire lines or coaxial cables, after some amount of time, you can feel that heat, right? So even in case of optical fiber also, due to this material composition and during the fabrication process, the discrepancies happen. Due to that, the material loss happens. Okay. So here what will happen? The power is dissipated as a heat in the waveguide, in the optical fiber. Now basically there are three. Again, absorption is one mechanism which will cause attenuation. Okay. Again, further, absorption of light may be caused by some of the mechanisms. Further, we have divided into three. One is the absorption may be by some atomic defects. This is about the structure I'm talking. Okay. Atomic defects in the glass composition while making the while fabricating the optical fiber. One is the other one is intrinsic absorption by basic constituent atoms of fiber material. You know what is intrinsic material already. You have come across this intrinsic semiconductors, I guess, right? Intrinsic and extrinsic. Intrinsic means a semiconductor in its purest form, you call it intrinsic, and extrinsic, you add impurities. So even here also, we can have some relative definition. Intrinsic absorption means it is whatever the absorption mechanism takes place in a pure glass, in the pure optical fiber cable, that we call it intrinsic absorption. We will see, even though it is so pure, what is the reason behind it that absorption happens. And the third one, the third mechanism which is categorized in absorption is extrinsic absorption. You know it, adding impurities. So because of some impure atoms in this glass material while fabricating, so because of this, some amount of absorption takes place, that is a loss which will cause the attenuation. So we will look into each one of these in detail. First one, absorption by atomic defects. Atomic defects, these are the imperfections in the atomic structure. I'm talking about the silica, because that your that is the main you know the material to fabricate the optical fiber cable. Okay, so what may be these imperfections? What are the defects? What variety of defects may exist? Some examples I have taken here. Missing of some molecules. Okay, that may be one thing. Then high density clusters of atomic groups. In the sense, the atoms, they are clustered, means they are made up into groups. Okay, and at some places they'll be at very higher concentration, and some will be at lower concentration. So that is clusters of atomic groups. So these examples I have taken as imperfections. Okay, and usually, whatever the losses that are happening because of these atomic defects, they are very negligible. Okay, negligible compared to the other two, that is intrinsic and extrinsic mechanisms. However, they are significant when the fiber is exposed to ionizing radiation. Hope you remember during the initial concepts. When we were dealing with the advantages and disadvantages of optical fiber cables, I think one of the disadvantage we have listed, hope you remember, that is darkening effect. Okay, something like that. So that is when your optical fiber is exposed to nuclear radiations. Okay, under such atmosphere, when you expose it to such environment, ionization takes place, because of which the nucleus of your whatever the fabric you have made of. So the nucleus of that, the structure will change. What will happen? There will be a breakage, chances of breakage of the optical fiber. That is darkening effect. So it is significant. This first mechanism is significant when the optical fiber is exposed to ionizing radiation in case of nuclear reactors, or even sometimes you go for x-rays, right? Some harmful radiations, a CT scan, MRIs, so medical radiation therapies, even sometimes space missions also. Okay, under such hazardous environments, if you use optical fibers, so there may be a chance of this kind of defect. So that radiation that comes out of these different examples which I have shown you, nuclear reactors, medical therapies, space missions, these radiations, they damage the internal structure of the fiber. As I told you, the nucleus, the structure of the nucleus will change. Okay, so these damages are proportional to the intensity of ionizing particles. Kitna intense rahega, kitna jitna strong rahega, utna hi damage zyada hoga. So this results in increasing attenuation. Obviously, ionizing particles agar zyada hai to damage utna hi zyada hoga. It means zyada absorption hoga, zyada attenuation hoga due to the atomic defects that absorbs optical energy. Now, the total damage a material receives, it is expressed in rad, R-A-D, in SI units. I should be capital. A rad indicates, I have written here, hope it is visible to you. Let me zoom it a little. Is it visible to you? I have written in pencil. Radiation absorption dose, D-O-S-E. Rad stands for radiation absorption dose. Don't consider rad means radiance. It is measuring the this radiation, hazardous radiations that comes out in that hazardous environment. Those radiations, ionized particles, that is measured in radiation absorption dose, in rads. Okay, what is this rad? It is the amount of energy absorbed in certain amount, in certain space. Okay, in a particular place. Okay, for example, ek space hai, one area it has. Within this area, if you divide this into number of squares, I'm just giving you one example to understand, to make you understand. So let me take only this part of the area. So rad indicates how much amount of energy is absorbed within this area. Okay, that is called rad. Let me zoom out. Okay, that is called rad. So this is the unit for measuring the radiation absorbed in bulk. Okay, so sometimes I think you have even heard about this radiation, how it is measured, Becquerel, and I don't know, you might have heard about this, these hazardous radioactive elements, okay, when they affect, how they are measured. You can just try to Google out and try to search. Okay, so this is one unit which is measured for radiation absorbed, and roughly this rad is equal to 0.01 joules per kg. In the sense, per kg jitna amount jo hai aapka isme 0.01 energy, you know, will be what the radiation gets absorbed. That is the amount of energy we are talking about per kg. Okay, and obvious hai that they are directly related. Jitna radiation ka intensity zyada hoga, utna zyada damage hoga optical fiber, and utna zyada attenuation hoga. That is given here in the form of a graph. You can see the x-axis represents this rad, that is radiation absorption dose. So this is horizontal, and this is your attenuation expressed in decibels per kilometer. You can see jitna aapka absorption, this energy deposited jitna zyada rahega, ionized particles radiation intensity jitna zyada hoga, utna hi attenuation zyada hoga. Okay, this is about the first, that is the absorption due to the atomic defects. Okay, which is very less in general, but however, it is more significant only in certain specific applications like nuclear reactors or some medical therapies, medications, or even some in case of some space missions. If you use, when you expose the optical fiber to a hazardous environment where the ionizing particles, the intensity, the radiation intensity is too high, under such condition, this may affect and the attenuation may be more. Coming to the second one, that is the second type of absorption mechanism, that is intrinsic absorption. Okay? As I told you, intrinsic absorption means this is due to the, it is for pure silica glass, the pure optical fiber. Let me just take one more slide. It's here. Okay, it's here. First, I'll read out this. What is intrinsic absorption? Then we can go to that graph and all. Intrinsic absorption, the spelling is RI. It occurs whenever the optical fiber is absolutely pure. Okay, with a pure, highly, with the precise fabrication processes, the techniques when you manufacture the optical fiber in its pure form. Okay, with no imperfections and no impurities in it, in such optical fiber, this intrinsic absorption may exist. Okay, so we will see what may be the reason this may exist, because even though it is so pure, what happens inside the optical fiber that some attenuation is taking place, even though it is so pure. So the very first thing is, this mechanism, intrinsic absorption, may result from two mechanisms. First one is electronic absorption bands in a UV region. You know, the total spectrum is divided into number of frequencies. So this is UV region and IR region. Within this region itself, if you remember, your optical fibers communication takes place, right? I had even asked you to go through the spectrum. Hope you have done that. So this is electronic absorption. Let's see what is electronic absorption. There are actually two types. One is electronic absorption bands, and the second one is atomic absorption bonds near. Okay, this is your band. This is your bond. Remember, bonds near IR region. So UV and infrared regions. So what is the first mechanism is, this absorption occurs whenever a light particle, that is, you know that optical fiber jab hum lete hain, light wave propagates inside. So this light is nothing but a photon, right? Light energy is nothing but photons in the form of packets, small tiny packets. So this photon, light particle, it interacts with the electrons present in the valence band. I am talking about this optical fiber. Optical fiber is made of what? Silica. silica is nothing but your sand, Si. Si has got some valence electrons in its outermost orbit. Those valence electrons, if they react, if they interact with this photon, they get excited due to the higher energy levels. Try to understand, whenever the light enters, even though the optical fiber is pure, the ideally what should happen, this should smoothly propagate and reach the destination. And this light wave is carrying some information. But what is happening here, even the optical fiber is very much pure in its purest form, what is happening? The light energy, which is nothing but your tiny packets photon, this photon reacts with the electrons present in the valence band. Valence band of what? Your optical fiber. Optical fiber in the sense silicon, Si. Actually, SiO2 you use. So, it's silicon. The valence electrons, what all are present, those interact with the photon. And this photon, jo bhi light ja raha hai, wo kya hoga? It will interact with the electrons of this and it will get excited to a higher energy level. So that, what will happen? So, whenever they get excited to another level, what should happen? The energy gets absorbed. It will not propagate through much of the energy. So when they excited to a higher energy level, the absorption takes place. This is one mechanism. The second one is atomic absorption bond. I'm talking about band. Here it was band. Here it is bonds I'm talking about. You know, covalent bond, you know, those bonds in chemistry you have studied. So atomic absorption in near IR region. This is caused by the vibration of SiO band. So when we are taking silicon, you know, the optical fiber is made up of this sand, silica. So it is actually SiO2 oxidized form. SiO2 again has got silicon and the oxide. So there will be a band present in between, right? Hopefully, you know what kind of band it exists. So silicon and this oxide, it will be having a band. So whenever this band fluctuates, okay, so the interaction between the vibration bonds and the electromagnetic field of the optical signal, you know, whenever we consider an optical fiber cable, when the light propagates in this, different modes occur, right? Modes in the sense what? Different configurations of your electric and magnetic fields. Okay, this is your single mode, right? We have already seen at the center, it is maximum. That's why in the core region, most of the energy is concentrated. We have already studied in the modes of a planar guide, waveguide. So whenever this light energy enters, that is nothing but your photons. So this will interact with this, the electromagnetic field of this light energy, it will interact with the vibration bonds. What are these bonds? This is between the bond is between Si and O, that is optical fiber. So because of this, what will happen? The absorption happens and the whatever light energy, actually ye jo light carry kar raha hai, the information wo actually passed hona tha, but wo optical fiber ke jo Si and O ke bonds hain, wo vibration se wo interact karke, it will lose the energy. ये जो वेव प्रोपोगेट हो रही है, दिस लाइट एनर्जी, जो भी वो पावर कंटेन करेगा, दैट विल लूज इट्स एनर्जी टू दैट बॉन्ड्स. सो लाइट एनर्जी इज ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फील्ड टू द बॉन्ड, SiO बॉन्ड. सो इन दिस वे एनर्जी इज लॉस्ट. सो इन बोथ केसेस, आइदर इट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक एब्जॉर्प्शन और एटॉमिक एब्जॉर्प्शन, इन बोथ द केसेस, इन द फर्स्ट केस द energy levels gets higher and absorption happens. In the second, transfer of energy takes place from electromagnetic field to the bond. In both the cases, absorption takes place and there is attenuation. So we are talking about the transmission characteristics. Transmission characteristics, we are now into attenuation and dispersion. There are two types. So attenuation, we are studying about the material absorption. So, ये हम जो भी पढ़ रहे हैं, intrinsic, atomic defects, extrinsic, these are all the mechanisms which in turn will cause attenuation. At the end result is attenuation. हमारा signal attenuate होके जाएगा. Okay? So I hope you understood about the intrinsic absorption. Even though silicon, this optical fiber, it is in its purest form, without any imperfections, no impurities added into it. Because of this structure, you know, some absorption takes place. One is when the light energy, the photons, they interact with the electrons present in the valence band. So higher energy level ko excite honge, absorption ho jayega. Second is atomic absorption. Yahan pe kya hoga? These whatever silicon and the oxide, there exists certain bond. So that bond, they'll be vibrating. This will interact with the electromagnetic field of the light signal. Because of which the light energy, jo bhi hai, jo bhi signal carry kar raha hai, that is transferred from that field, EM field, electromagnetic wave, jo ja raha hai, that field to the SiO bond. So these are the two main causes for intrinsic absorption. Now let us go to that graph which I had drawn here. Okay, so you can see. So again, the same thing I have explained here. An absolute pure, okay, here I have written pure silica glass has a little intrinsic absorption in its pure form without any impurities due to some material structure. As I have explained you, one is electronic, one is atomic, two absorptions. So here in short, I have mentioned in a near infrared region and one is UV region. Two regions are there. However, it does have two major intrinsic absorption mechanisms at optical wavelengths, which leave low intrinsic absorption window over this. The meaning of this is, let me explain you the meaning of this, what all I have written here. There is a graph here, you can observe. This horizontal axis, the lower one indicates the photon energy, that is in electron volts. Ye aapka light wave jo travel kar raha hai, wo energy indicate kar raha hai. And the above line indicates the wavelength. Just try to compare. Okay, yahan par 0.6, 0.8. So energy aise ja rahi hai, increasing order. But if you see the wavelength across here, it is like this. Starting from somewhere 0.7, 0.8, 0.9. Okay, so this is your wavelength. This is your energy, photon energy. And ye kya hai? Attenuation indicate kar raha hai, vertical line. So majorly here, two lines are very important as for now. Because we are now into absorption only. This line and this line. These two lines are important as for now. Ye jo baki jo lines dikh rahe hai aapko, they are related to your next type of the mechanism which causes attenuation, that is scattering. Okay, we are not going to see it now. But now you can see the orange lines. They depict the attenuation. Observe karo yahan pe. I've listed here. For UV, for this line, okay, for this line I'm talking, whenever the lambda is increasing, loss is less. Observe, lambda jaise jaise increase ho raha hai, okay, loss kam hote ja raha hai, fine. And for IR, the second absorption, that is I'm talking about electronic absorption and this IR absorption. That is atomic absorption. So that is infrared absorption. For the second type of absorption, ulta ho jayega. When I take the lambda lesser, loss kam ho jayega. You can observe as I'm going here from higher value to lower value of lambda, ab attenuation kam hote ja raha hai. Okay, dono mein reverse case hai. And what I have mentioned here, the optical, you know, the wavelengths, jo optimum ek low intrinsic absorption window hai, that is between these two lines. Let me just erase this a little bit. So that is 0.8 to 1.7 micrometer. So I have just encircled here wavelength 0.8 and 0.7. So ye jo range hai, don't take these things. Okay, I'm not into the electron volts. I'm not telling you that. I am now talking about this range, 0.8 to 1.7. This is your optimum range. Agar is range ke wavelength mein agar aap work karoge, so you will get lower intrinsic absorptions. hope you understand what do you mean by a window. In the initial sessions, we have discussed some introductory parts where we have discussed about the advantages, historical developments, as well as the spectrum. When we take the spectrum of frequencies, we take that range of frequencies, we take it as a spectrum. If you take the range of wavelengths, we call it a window. Okay, even that was one work also given to you to do. Hope you have done that. So window is what? Range of wavelengths. So between 0.8 to 1.7, ye optimum range of wavelength hai. Jahan pe agar aap work karoge within this range, you will get low intrinsic absorption. Figure shows a possible optical attenuation against the wavelength characteristics. The same thing, I have explained it in words. It may be observed that there is a fundamental absorption edge, the peaks of which are centered in the UV wavelength region. This is due to the stimulation of electron transition within the glass. This, what I have given you, this is nothing but the two types of absorptions I'm explaining here indirectly. See, whenever the transition happens, the glass with the higher energy excitations in the first type, electronic absorption, what will happen? Photons, they interact with the valence electrons of this optical fiber and they get excited to a higher energy level. Okay, and then the second one, that is atomic absorption. And here I'm giving you one of the details, that is the peaks of both, it may be UV or IR absorptions, the peaks of, they are centered in the UV length region. Okay, this is depicted because of the spectrum we are taking, UV and IR. This is due to the stimulation, the reason we are giving. And the tail of this peak may extend into the window region at a shorter wavelengths as shown. Indirectly, I'm telling you, this is your optimum region over which you will not get this intrinsic absorption. Ye ek range hai, 0.8 se 1.7 tak. Now coming to the extrinsic absorption, the third mechanism which will cause the absorption and in turn attenuation. So in practice, let me just read the last slide, then we can go to this. Extrinsic absorption, it is caused by the impurities. So jo intrinsic tha, pure tha, extrinsic in the sense, some impurities exist in the optical fiber, maybe during the manufacturing. Earlier days, precise fabrication techniques were not there. So earlier, there was a very much chance that extrinsic absorption do exist. But nowadays, you have seen such a high precise fabrication techniques you have got. So many techniques with which pure, most of the impurities you eliminate. Okay, so this is very, chances are less nowadays, but earlier it was very much. So this extrinsic absorption, it results, first one is from the transition metal impurities. So you might be knowing about in the periodic table, some transition metal group is also there, right? So what are those such metals? Examples are given here. Iron, cobalt, copper, chromium. Some examples I've given you. These are some transition metals. So jab ye add honge, that may result in extrinsic absorption. And one more is OH ions. OH is nothing but water, okay? But however, it is actually what? Hydroxyl group. OH indicates hydroxyl group. Ye water, aapko, don't think that water kaise rahega optical fiber mein. It is actually in the glass, this OH, the group, this ions, they are dissolved while making the glass. These OH ions are dissolved. So these may be two reasons. One more reason is what? This may also occur because of the charge transition from one ion to the another ion. So because of these reasons, extrinsic absorption may happen. So extrinsic absorption, it is caused by the electronic transition of these impurity ions. So electronic transition, they change, the ionic positions will change. You might be knowing, agar aap aise Fe likhenge, so it's in purest form. If you take this, this indicates an ion. So agar aap ye transition hote jayega, okay, plus 2, plus 3, something like that. Wo apna, they keep changing. So that is what? The transition. They keep on making the transition from one energy level to the another energy level, either gaining or losing. Okay. So losses can be up to 1 to 10 decibels per kilometer, which is high compared to what we expect. We expect from optical fiber cable is that 0.1 dB attenuation we want per kilometer. Coaxial cable, it is much greater. Probably, I think 0 to 1 to 10 mean in the sense coaxial cable range mein hi aa gaya hai. So this can be, we can reduce this extrinsic absorption. How? With the help of glass refining techniques. As I'm telling you, nowadays you have got so much of development in the technology. Even this glass fabrication, it has got many different steps involved. So the most pure, you can try to eliminate this by, you know, impurities. Eliminate kar sakte ho. How we can avoid this extrinsic absorption with the help of glass refining techniques. And another major loss, this is caused by OH ions, as I said, hydroxyl group. So let me just go back and read this. So in practical, the optical fibers that are prepared by conventional melting techniques, which were earlier, olden days, we were not having much precise techniques, as I told you. So a major source of signal attenuation is extrinsic absorption. Okay, kyunki transition metals add ho jayenge. So some of the common transition metals are, I had listed earlier, there is chromium, there is copper, there is Fe, there is nickel, magnesium, I don't know what is V4+, so please try to find out what is this V, because I'm very much poor with this periodic table right now. Even this, whatever the impurities that are found in the glasses, here I have listed here, in the form of ionic impurities, okay? You can see plus sign indicates it is in the form of an ion. And this is your peak wavelength at which it is operating. And one part in this, how much impurity is there in one part in 10 raised to 9? It indicates that. So this, there is a table given here. You can go through the table for a wavelength 625, this much one part, 1.6 in 10 raised to 9. So that much impurity gets added. Mostly it is here 2.7. Fine. So transition element contamination we can reduce by how? By glass refining techniques. Again, it is repeated. Glass refining techniques in the sense, you might have gone through these processes somewhere in chemistry or so. Vapor phase oxidization, which largely eliminates the effects of these impurities. Earlier, it was more prominent, but now it has reduced. However, another major loss of mechanism is by this OH ions, addition of this OH ions. Actually, OH is nothing but hydroxyl group. Ye water content indicate karega, but not actually the water in the optical fiber. Okay, but it is in the material while fabricating, these ions gets dissolved. Okay, the meaning is that. So these are bounded into, they are dissolved into the glass structure, and they have a fundamental stretching vibration. See, when you add, when these ions get dissolved in the optical fiber, what will happen? It will have a fundamental stretching vibrations, which will occur at some specific wavelengths. Okay, so you can see here at the end, I have given you the graph also. At specific wavelengths between 2.7 to 4.2 micrometer, within this range, if you are operating, so if your optical fiber has this OH hydroxyl group dissolved into it while fabricating, so what will happen between this wavelength range, stretching vibrations do exist, because of which what will happen is these vibrations, they give rise to overtones. So you might have studied about overtones. They are harmonics, simple harmonics. Okay, in sound waves concept, you have studied overtones. So they harmonically, you know, they frequently at some specific time intervals, they repeat. They become maximum and then they'll get lower. They are harmonics. And they are specifically, they come at, in the figure, these three wavelengths have been shown. See? This is your wavelength shown. This is your attenuation. And these peaks of the waves indicates harmonics or the overtones, what you call. You can see this is the peak. At this, the first overtone exists. This is all because of the vibrations. This is because stretching vibrations. Okay. And the second, this first overtone is at 1400 wavelength nanometer. Second overtone is somewhere around 950. Third overtone, 750. So at these three wavelengths, specific wavelengths, overtones or harmonics come. I've given here 1.38 in that sense, approximately 14. That is 1.4, that is 1400. 0.95 means around 950 or, here it is 950. Or 0.72 means 750, around 750 somewhere I have given here. So these are the overtones. They are formed harmonically at these three wavelengths. I have given you the details. So we have discussed in the absorption three major things. One is the due to the atomic defects, why, how the absorption takes place. Then second one, we have seen intrinsic absorption, that is due to two different mechanisms. One is your electronic absorption. The other one is atomic absorption. The first one is electronic absorption, that is UV absorption. Atomic absorption is IR absorption. Then we have seen the graph also. After that, we have come across extrinsic absorption due to some impurities, that is a transition metal impurities or hydroxyl groups. If these two gets added into the optical fiber while fabricating, so these may result in absorption. Hope you understood this. In the next session, we are going to deal with linear scattering losses. Any doubts, you can ask me.